are drawn to water, and there is so much water in Yellowstone, even though we are kind of in a high desert environment. It is everywhere. So rivers, lakes, hundreds of waterfalls, and then the big things that people really come to see, geysers and hot springs. It could be solid or gas. It can flow very quietly and slowly. It can be loud and roaring and raging and fast. And then you have Yellowstone Lake, which is like an ocean in the middle of our continent. The variety of water we have here, I think it really makes Yellowstone pretty special.
Fishing is obviously a really, really popular thing in Yellowstone, and people come and fish these rivers, both because they're beautiful rivers to fish, but they're cold waters fed by mountain snows, and they contain native trout that depend on cold, oxygen-rich water. Yellowstone is a stronghold for native Yellowstone cutthroat trout, but Yellowstone is a stronghold for lots of aquatic organisms, not just trout, but 4 species of native amphibians that are widespread throughout this place. Water is important for loons that are uncommon in this region. We know that beaver and moose, we know that grizzly bears, we know that elk, we know that bison all use shallow surface water habitats on a regular basis.
I was drawn to work with water because I come from the desert where it's sparse and there's very little of it. And so you really notice just the magnetic nature of water, how dependent life is to it, and how much it's drawn to being toward water. Yesterday, we were working on a special project that was related to a mine cleanup outside of Yellowstone National Park. So I was helping to collect water samples and do water chemistry measurements to see how the cleanup was affecting water quality running into the park.
Yesterday, we were working on Soda Butte Creek, which is a really interesting tributary that comes into the park at its northeast boundary. Soda Butte Creek was, at one time, one of the most contaminated rivers entering a national park in the U.S. And an interesting reclamation project spearheaded by a collaboration between the Montana Department of Environmental Quality and the National Park Service led to a cleanup effort that removed toxins that had the potential to enter Yellowstone National Park. That cleanup was successful, and we've been working on a water quality project that demonstrates that conditions in Soda Butte Creek that flows into the Lamar River and ultimately the Yellowstone River have been cleaned.
Water is life, and water really drives the system. That's definitely something of interest for our scientists because with climate change, water patterns may change. Snow and rain patterns may change.
In the Rockies, we store most of our water as snow. It's delivered all winter long and then released slowly through the early summer. So changes in snowpack will lead to changes in water storage and therefore changes in river flows. Freshwater habitats, and in particular shallow wetlands and ponds, are things that are the most vulnerable to a changing climate. And so we should do everything we can to both understand but protect remaining habitats.
Those healthy rivers that are flowing out of the park are also providing a great resource downstream for everything from farmers and ranches, cities, towns. You know, we need water. And so having these healthy waterways in a national park is actually providing a lot for the folks downstream. It's kind of fun when you're by a river in Yellowstone to think about the journey that that water will take, where it has been, where it has come from, and where it will go.